learning anything about your team within season, or is this just what you've seen in practice?
No, I think we're improving. This thing, we have to do things a little bit longer. You know, I think we did it for good stretches, and then in the second half, for whatever reason, the ball just started sticking. You know, we had, you know, 7 block shots and only 2 foul shots in the first half. Seven, just, you know, that's the way it was. So if they're going to call the game that way, and in no way am I saying that I thought it was a poorly officiated game. I thought the game was called well, but we established that going to the basket, they weren't giving us fouls, so we have a little spray. We did that in the first half to the tone of getting, you know, 8 3-pointers. Then we didn't do it in the second half, and that's where those errant shots, and, you know, at the basket lead to runouts, and where they don't have to come out and play against our half-court defense. They got back into the game that way. So again, for us, it's just growing in that area, being able to understand what's going on. You know, we're not gonna win many games. We got 10 assists in the first half and only 3 in the second half. That's not who we are. That's not how we play. And but you know, again, nothing with the wrong with the effort of trying, but it's just, again, a little more attention to detail. Their main guys play 36, 37 minutes, so I'm not gonna put it on fatigue. It's just a matter of want to. Once they got back into the game and they kind of sensed that we were on our heels, they took it up a notch, and we got to find a way to battle adversity and still be able to, you know, find that next level. And I think that's just part of our program.
Is it sometimes just an extra pass or pulling up from mid range instead of taking it in on some of those block shots that turn the run off?
Yeah, I mean, I think we go back and watch it, we're going to see that there's guys wide open. You know what I'm saying? They converge on us, you know, they're shrinking kind of in between, and we didn't make those plays the way that we did in the first half. The ball was hopping, we had some guys, everybody converged. I think Brady Apple's play really stand out for me because he was under the basket, everybody eyes on him, he kicks out to a wide open 3, and those shots tend to go in for us because they're the right shots, and guys have time to really get their feet set and step into them with confidence. But, you know, but it's not from the standpoint of, it's just, I want to do it. I want to do it. It's like they want to get it done as opposed to we need to do it. And those are just kind of things that we continue to harp on and try to make sure that we execute better next time. You know, it's a really good team. I mean, we felt like we had them in a similar position that we had them last time, but I don't think it was our defense so much that let us down this time.
Coach Moyer played some good minutes in the first half, but didn't play as much in the second half. Was that kind of just waiting for Obino to get a foul trouble?
Yeah, some of it. I mean, this, you know, Matt, he had some moments, and he had some tough moments in the second half. Going to the offensive board, you know, with a team that want to push it like that, so we don't have time for all of the, you know, flopping, fifth flail, trying to get, you know, a call. Get in the call, you know, get back. You know? So I think those things put us in a bad way. You know, and it wasn't just him, you know, just throughout the game. It's felt that, you know, the edge, you know, give us a bigger body on which just to be able to rebound. But again, like I said, we try to go kind of offense and defense, try to get a little more offense on the floor. But Matt, he didn't really get anything going offensively. So I guess we decided just to err on the side of having a little more defensive side in the game. You know what I'm saying?
You guys have faced some good bigs recently. First Perry, now Richards. How do you think your bigs have stacked up defending those guys?
I mean, our bigs, like I said, somebody asked a question about Dylan guarding 5. We don't want Dylan to have to guard 5. You know, that's out of necessity. That's not who we want to be. He's a 4-man, and you train him 1-3. He's guarding 1 perimeter. Not going the other way forward, having to try and, you know, go down there and bang the 5s. You know, I just think that's part of, you know, obviously losing Cleavon. But, you know, we feel good about that position moving forward. And, you know, because we have Quentin coming in, and he's, I think he's going to be a pleasant surprise for everybody. It's his smarts, his size, and his ability to understand what's going on the four sides of the floor. So, you know, we got some guys sitting over there that,
practices.
I'm pretty excited. I'm saying with DJ Harvey, the guy that just scored the ball, and you know, some of these shots that we're missing right now, we don't feel like we're taking these those shots in the future with some of the personnel that we're adding. But right now, it's giving, you know, great reps for our role players, the guys who play, you know, role players for us going forward. And like I said before, there's no shortage of fighting in our guys and trying to compete and win the game. We just got to do it a little bit smarter and do it together.
Coach, how gratifying is that? And, you know, you're improving the effort, the buy-in, the fact that your guys have fought the way they have, even when the results haven't always been there.
Yeah, it gets a little stale, you know what I'm saying? But it's good, you know what I'm saying? You like to get some wins at the end of it, you know? But then I think we will, you know what I'm saying? Just had a tough stretch here where we played probably a couple, two or three of the best in the conference. Maybe two or three of the best in the conference, I mean, in the country. I think as the season goes on, I think this state is a pretty good team. LSU obviously has shown what they've done, and Kentucky, I think it's more of just a, you know, again, as our talent pool increases, then a little bit of the separation from those teams change. And I think it comes down to our execution, our X and O's, and our schemes, which I think, you know, I put up against any of these teams to reflect. Just again, the sheer size, being able to box them out and, you know, not allowing it, you know, extra second chance points and different things like that, points in the paint. Just look at the comparison and the numbers at the end of the game. You see, like, we got to get more, you know, from inside the paint. The threes are good. I think we've got to figure out a formula that we can somewhere, try to be somewhere between 10 and 12, you know, and shoot free throws well. That we're going to give ourselves a good chance.
Was there anything Kentucky did coming out of the halftime that really slowed the offense down, or was it just shots not falling?
No, I mean, like I said, I think it was our poor decision making, you know, from getting in the paint and feeling like we want to challenge Nick Richards at the paint. And, you know, they feel like fouls because, you know, they kind of riding them, but the plays up top were clean, you know, and I think if they're not calling it, then we got to adjust, you know, not continue to try to force the issue and make them make the calls, just make the sprays, make the extra passes, get your teammates involved, and we can do that. We look back at it, that's what we're going to see. Nothing. And that ignited them to be able to get back in the game. We got a 9-point game. We don't want to foul at the end of the half to do those types of things. We, you know, built a 14-point lead and started to give it back before the half. And then in the second half, you know, our poor decisions led to them getting out of there. They're just like live ball turnovers. You go miss a layup, and you got guys deep in the corner, wide open, waiting to catch a shoot. Now they're, you know, putting a lot of pressure on them to have to get back and stop guys that's coming downhill full speed. And that's where they were able to get back in, and they got a lot of momentum, and we weren't able to recover from that.
Last one, Coach.
Is the free throw shooting just mentally?
Right, so.